Good job. I'm so proud of you, Linda. You do such a good job. This is a lot.
Recording.
Great.
Hi, Shelby.
Hello, Linda Kay. How are you?
I'm good. Before I start your reading, I want people to know that I am aware of you and I know what you do for a living, and we're going to discuss that later. And Shelby is married, so we're not going to talk about her love life.
But why not? I still have one.
Okay, then we'll talk about your husband. Let's see what I pick up about you and him together.
I'm excited. So I've known you for quite a few years now too, but we haven't spent a lot of real lifetime.
Through cruises, and I met you on one cruise.
I recall. But I feel like I know you more than some people I've spent time with physically, because we connect so much on social media.
We're both spiritual and metaphysical and stuff like that. So we have that in common.
Yeah.
So first of all, I'm going to start with your relationship with your husband, Joel. Mm-hmm. Let's see. Things are very good between you, but he's afraid of being not good enough for you. There's feelings within him, and I don't know if you see how he acts with you, but it's like he has this feeling that you're better than him, if that makes sense. He is very much in love with you. You are like you're the twinkle in his life. It's like if you can see the twinkle in his eyes, you both have that. And he wants you to succeed more than anything else in the world.
I think that's true.
You are feeling like you have to take him with you. Like, I know he does separate stuff, but you want him involved in all of your stuff, I feel, you know. And the two of you are going to wind up strictly doing your business together, the travel thing together. I feel eventually. And I feel like it's going to happen in 2022. By the year 2022, you're going to strictly be doing this business together. I know he does other things and he has another business.
Yeah.
But he's going to be going away from that eventually.
Wow.
And the two of you will be successful in this business together. You have a very powerful soulmate connection.
Yes.
And you have been in many lifetimes together.
I agree.
Like it was a lifetime in which, I don't know who is the male or female, but one of you was a teacher and the other was a student. And you learned in that lifetime, or he learned in that lifetime, a lot of things. And I feel like he has learned so much from you. And you've learned a lot from him, but you are like the prayer that was answered for him. Has he ever said anything like that to you?
Yeah. So first, I've never done anything like this before. I'm generally very scared of any, it's not that I don't believe in it, it's that I don't want to hear anything that would...
I do the positive.
Yeah, you mentioned that to me. I don't know why. It's always been something I'm very nerve-wracked to ever experience. So even that I'm open enough to do this with you.
I'm so happy that you would be able to do this.
Well, I really feel like we've bonded so much over the last year, and I know your heart is in such a good place and your intentions are just so pure. And we follow a lot of the same people too, which I know on a bigger scale, it means we have the same sort of belief systems on spiritual guidance. And anyway, to answer your question, yeah, I definitely agree with you. I think a lot of men in general do get that not good enough feeling, that sort of that always trying to level up to something. And he has mentioned that, not in a positive light, because he feels like he's always trying to get to the carrot. He's in front of his nose. But we have had a lot of challenges over the last 10 years that are very unconventional, that are not the norm.
You have lifted him up.
Yeah, for sure. And he would admit to that too.
A childhood in which he didn't feel like he was taken seriously, you know, and so he felt like, I feel like before he met you and maybe in the initial part, he didn't take himself seriously. And now he does.
I've always been, I tell anyone publicly that I've always been the biggest fan of Joel Fournette, and I could tell his potential and his, what his capabilities were way before he could. And I have been lifting that man up for a good 20 years, but I will say it did take a kind of a breaking point about 10 years ago, where I just, you know, he needed to level up his career and he was really selling himself short. I know a lot of people do this, you know, and I'm sure you know a lot of people that do this, but
he's doing a lot of great things now. And
yeah, now he leveled up. Like it has been such a cool journey to watch him, almost like a butterfly, you know. It's just,
I feel like he's gonna want to be more a part of your business.
Yeah, I hope so, because he is a critical part of anything I do, really. And these days, with technology really being almost at the heart of businesses rather than a sideline, you know, technology and being able to communicate in the most efficient way possible, he is such a whiz. I mean, he does everything. It's outrageous how much he understands. It's not just sales. It's not just marketing. It's not just the internet. It's everything, you know, from the building blocks to from the computer code up until the marketing aspect of things. So he is a very valuable asset to anyone that works with him. And I do use him a lot. He's a great trainer. And I have lifted him up, but this year I would say he's lifted me up more.
I know the history of what you've been doing. And I know that you started this business right before COVID. The travel business has been really hard for you. But you're going to see a lot of progress being made for yourself in the next 6 months. Things are going to speed up and they're going to flow.
I hope so. It's been a lot of sticking points. Yeah, we transitioned. We got in a partnership and I made there was several reasons. It wasn't really just a change that I wanted, but I wanted to grow. And I know I was at the stage that I had an opportunity to take the leadership role. Someone gave me the opportunity. And then the company I was with didn't want that to happen. So, you know, they basically just asked me to sign a non-compete after 15 years. It's like, that's not a good sign. So it kind of left me with having to, I really didn't have a choice at the end. I gave them my options and they forced me towards this one.
You know, it's going to be smooth sailing though, you know.
Yeah, it sure hasn't been.
Smooth sailing within the next 6 months. And I feel by April, you're going to have it all together and
April.
Be able to remove all the blocks. And that's only an approximate time frame. It could be before or it could be after. But it's just, I see it's like you're going with the wave.
Yeah.
Going with the wave.
You mean being crushed and tumbled
it's
on.
It's going to be worse, even more powerful than you think it is, because you better hold on. Hold on tight, because it's going to be like, whoa.
Oh, I hope so. That would be great. Yeah, it definitely seemed like the planets definitely aligned against me. So, and everyone in travel, really. I mean, I wouldn't even be working if I had stayed with the other company. For sure, they would have let me go like the rest of the people. But because we were such a small community and we were so tightly knit with the investors, we were able to continue going, you know, at least continue, you know, so. But I really am hoping to hang on to, because it's just.
Any specific cruises that you want to know about, like how it will go?
Well, I love the February cruise. We just launched that. That's the one that is a topless optional at the pool with Temptation. And yeah, I'm hoping like to give that, to me, it's opening a whole new life. Just like with my last company with the single sailings, people that got on board that were afraid because they thought, oh, being with a group of singles, we must be all the time naked and crazy. And it's not like that. You know, it's just a bunch of great people meeting more great friends. And when you bring them into that community, you feel like you've done a justice for that. You've helped them. You've like lifted them up. They become connected just like you have connected with so many great people. And I think that this is just another level to that game, even more fun, even more freeing, and something that a lot of people are very hesitant to do because
the tops optional is going to be successful eventually. People, mm-hmm. There are people that are afraid.
Yeah.
Going to be very hesitant, but I feel like it's going to be very popular.
Yeah.
You will have an opportunity to move people in that direction eventually.
Yeah.
It may not happen right away. I feel like it's, as far as COVID, we have no control over when the government decides to open everything up and the CDC and everything like that. I feel like the ships are going to start sailing in.
I don't know if you want to pot. There you go. I see you. Go ahead.
Oh,
it was frozen. Yeah, that's okay. We're back.
It's the first part of next year. I feel sometime in the first quarter of next year, everything is going to start to open up.
Yeah, I would think so. I mean, they already are open in Europe, which was hit pretty hard from what we saw in the news. But
no, especially Italy.
I know, and they're cruising out of Italy, so it's going well, but I know we don't hear that much.
I wanted you to tell people a little bit about what you do before we end, and tell them about your company and everything.
Yeah, well, thank you, Linda. So we do all travel. We're a travel agency, and we do specialize in groups and
singles.
Specifically singles, groups of singles. So we have several singles groups going out in November, February, and August. We're doing Ibiza. That's exciting. Yeah. You're coming on that one, right? Yeah. So that's fun. Yeah, we're trying to do groups, and we're also working on something that keeps, for whatever reason, little blocks get in my way, but we will finish this project. However, COVID got in the way, and then of course we had some family situations that got in the way, but we're gonna be doing the ambassador training, group leader training program that's gonna be launching very soon, and that has been on the list of things to do for quite some months, but it wasn't the right timing when COVID came out. And I know it is now, but we just had a lot of things come up that were unexpected. But that is exciting to try and basically share the knowledge that I've gained over the years of building groups and taking people out and trying to share that and give that gift to everyone else that wants to be a part of it. And I know there's a lot of people that love to travel and want a few discounts, and they can get those referral discounts with the group leader without making it a big business commitment. And we'll do a travel agent training too for those people that are more serious about wanting to make income on the side. But that's an exciting.
I would be interested.
Yeah, that you would be great. I mean, you have a very good leadership and a huge network, and you'll love it. I think it's going to be worth everyone's time, but. It's a nice gift. It feels good to give, and I've been wanting to just do it at the right time. Yeah, it's happening. It's going to happen soon. I want to say this weekend, but I don't want to commit to any date.
Why don't you tell people about the Temptation Cruise?
Yes, so the
singles as well as couples.
Yeah, singles and couples. So we just partnered with Temptations, which is a Tops optional area, has at the resort and on their cruise. So they have basically at the pool and outside, Tops are optional. And it's a very friendly, frisky, wild, fun time. They definitely have a energy freeing and non-judgmental, and I'm really excited to experience it myself, but I've had quite a few trainings on it now with a gal who has been there for 15 years, and Sylvina, we just interviewed her, and gosh, she is just such a neat soul too. I think you'd really connect with her. But yeah, it's just something new, something a little wild, you know, and well, I think we need a little bit of wild.
I'm used to, I live at Caliente Clothing Optional Resort.
Yeah, I know.
And I'm used to nudity and clothing optional. And
right.
It's a part of my life for a very long time. I've lived at Caliente for 17 years. If I can, I would love to go on the February cruise because I would love that. And I think that we should call out to all the singles who want to go on that cruise. We're going to think positive and say it's going to go. But
I've thought they were all going to go, but I definitely think they will go. And travel.fun is where you can find the info on that February cruise. So yeah. I will put that in there.
I know that I would be very comfortable in that.
Oh, yeah, you sure would.
And since it's singles and couples, all you people, if you're single, all ages, but I'm calling out to all the guys that are older than 55.
For you personally?
Personally.
That's great. I love it.
I think it would be a lot of fun, but you really need to say and let people know that they don't swing out in the open. Nobody swings in the open. What goes on behind closed doors, that's fine, but that doesn't happen. I know somebody that performs on that cruise, on the last one, and she said it was tame.
That's great. Compared to in a sense of people that are not familiar with that lifestyle or comfortable with it, that are kind of dipping their toes in it, that's my understanding is that the cruise, especially for people that like to cruise, like the people we know, it's really just a way to go get a little wilder. It's not crazy. And it's like you said, behind closed doors. And this goes for all cruises and all groups. Right. Whenever we get together with the singles, you know, people are adults. What goes behind closed doors, that's okay. It's just what we're allowing to be in public area. The morale will be high. The energy will be high. It won't make you feel uncomfortable. No one's there to make you feel uncomfortable. And you're just there to have fun and experience something that you haven't experienced before, which these days I think is really exciting.
I've been to Hedonism in Jamaica 3 times, and that was wild.
Yeah, and in comparison to that, it is tame. From my understanding, from people that have done both, it is not that wild. Hedonism, and again, I have no judgment. Whatever anybody likes to do, it's fine by me. I know my comfort level is probably a little bit more middle of the road, and hedonism seems a little bit out of my comfort level from the experiences I've heard about. But the cruise and the Temptations Resort, I think I'm going to love it. But I'm going to let you know because I'm going to check it out.
Resort as well. You know,
yeah.
Wouldn't mind going there.
Yeah, we're looking at Halloween. We're seeing if there's have any space left for Halloween to do like a last minute thing. Because Cancun is allowing everybody in. There's they have low numbers and the restrictions are lifted, and they have safety precautions in place. They've been open the whole time, so they do have Halloween open. I just don't know how many rooms they have because I know it's super popular. So I just checked yesterday to see if we could promote a little group, even if there's 10 or 20 rooms that we sell, just to have a group of people that know each other that might want to go, because I know no one's doing anything for Halloween anymore because all the cruises got canceled.
I love going on Halloween cruises. You know,
it's fun.
So many singles and stuff like that. It's just so cool.
It is. It is a lot of fun. It is a lot of fun. And I'm excited about getting back to fun. I want everybody to be safe. I know they're taking all these precautions that they need to. I feel like we're ready. I mean, it's been about 6 months now, so it's getting towards that opening phase. We're in phase three here. I don't know how you guys are looking over in Land Lakes. How are you guys?
Oh, the governor opened it up to everyone.
Oh, okay. Okay, great. So it's not looking worse. If we're on an up, we're on a positive.
Well, you know, you can still wear masks if you want.
Right.
I'll be wearing masks in the grocery store, and I mm-hmm. hope that others will too. The idea is to stay safe, but we're going to get through this. I know we are, and yeah. I've always felt that way.
Well, this has been fun,
Shelby.
Yes, you are so fun, Linda. Thank you so much for taking the time out and giving us some insight. And I really enjoyed it, even though I was scared. So for those of you who are scared, take the chance. It's worth it. It feels good. And she's really given me some hope, really. So thank you for that. I appreciate it.
You're travel.fun.
Yes, travel.fun. Yep, that's right.
And I am pinkchickpsychic.com.
Pinkchickpsychic.com. Love it.
Yes. And I want you all to have a fabulous, pinkalicious life and day. And hope we get to cruise soon.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Bye, Linda.